Hello and welcome to the new series of Drishti IAS. I am Pooja Dwivedi, and in this segment we are going to discuss the ongoing tussle between the governor and the CM in Kerala over three farm bills. So let's begin with the topics of discussion step by step. And we must know that this topic is important from the perspective of prelims as well as GS mains paper too. So let's begin with why in news. First we will discuss that. Then we will talk about the timeline of the recent events that are going on. We will talk about important provisions of the constitution which says what the government should do, the governor should do and the state government should do. Alright, we will talk about the important judgments with respect to the role of the governor in the state, and we will talk about the efforts of the central government in order to harmonize the working between the center and the states. Then we will discuss the challenges, the way forward, and in the midst of the segment, I am going to ask you a pre-based question for which if you know the answer, kindly comment in the comment segment. Let's begin with why in news? Because the governor has been mulling the appeal of this chief minister of Kerala for a debate assembly to be conducted in order to debate over the three farm bills. So this has been going on since a long time. So we will first see what is the timeline of the events. First, of course, in a letter to the governor, Mr. Vijayan, who is the chief minister of Kerala, said that Kerala depended hugely on other states for its supply for food, and the farmers' agitation in the country's agriculture production center has created much anxiety in the state. Of course, all the states are anxious right now because their revenue is getting lost, right? Although the government has made certain amendments, certain offers, but still there is a lot of anxiety. What will happen in the long run? And then the chief minister said that the chief minister forcefully rejected Governor Khan's contention that there is no such need to conduct a debate assembly over three farm bills. Now here what has happened, the federal structure according to Mr. Vijayan is getting threatened, right? And he is constantly trying to pursue the governor to summon the assembly, right? So that is the power of the governor, right? So that is what has happened. Now if we talk about the next set, he reminded the governor that the government was bound by the council of ministers advice, especially if they are in the power with the help of majority, and the governor had no discretionary power in the matter. Now the Supreme Court had upheld certain constitutional principle in several litigations. Now see, harmonizing of the relationship of the states as well as the center must be there in order to protect the federal structure of the country. And also the governor should not also be treated as political football, right? So let's see what are the important provisions of the constitution. Kindly note it down and already take a screenshot even. According to Article 153, there shall be a governor for each state, and according to Article 163, there shall be a council of ministers with the chief minister at the head to aid and advise the governor in the exercise of his functions. See, here the chief minister should be the head of the council of ministers and he should advise and aid the governor in the exercise of his functions. Of course, there is a harmony of power over here given by the constitution. Except insofar as he is by or under the constitution required to exercise his functions or any of them in his discretion. Now, this particular line says that he should be guided by the help of the council of ministers until and unless there are provisions, there are certain factors which are contributing to the conclusion that his discretionary power, the governor's discretionary power, should be practiced. That means he should go by his own wishes in the sense it should not fall outside the constitution of India, right? Then next, if any question arises whether any matter or is there or is not a matter of as respects which the governor is by or under this constitution required to act in his discretion, the decision of the governor in his discretion shall be final, and the validity of anything done by the governor shall not be called in question on the ground that he ought or ought not to have acted in his discretion. Now, if we talk about this particular statement, it says that whether the matter falls into the discretion of the governor or not is the final. The final say here will be of the governors, and it can't be called into question, right? Next, this line says the question whether any, and if so, what advice was tendered by the ministers to the governor shall not be inquired into any court. Whatever the ministers or the council of ministers, basically whatever they are giving the advice to the governor shall not be asked into any courts. This is also an important provision. And Article 174 says that the governor shall from time to time summon the house or each house of the legislature of the state to meet at such time and place as he thinks fit. Of course, the power to summon a house over here is falling under the ambit of the governor, right? And also there is one more important line that you need to see here, that 6 months shall not be left out between its last sitting in one session and the date appointed for its first sitting in the next session. Please keep the time period in mind over here. Next, we will discuss the important judgments regarding the role of the governor. So a number of rulings by the Supreme Court have happened in the past because there is a lack of harmony between the governor and the CM or the state governments. And it is not new in India that there has been a conflict of power. The power needs to be balanced, and then comes the Supreme Court. And Supreme Court had settled the position that the governor cannot refuse the request of a cabinet that enjoys majority, of course, in the House, unless it is patently unconstitutional, right? It should mean if it's constitutional and the party or the cabinet enjoys the majority, then of course the governor is bound by the aid of the or the request of the Council of Ministers. Is similarly, if you remember that there was a power tussle between the LG of Delhi and the popularly into majority Arvind Kejriwal, the CM of Delhi, in which the 5-judge bench said that the LG should act with the aid and advice of the Council of Ministers, and he should not be absolute in his or her exercise of power. And then similarly, the latest in the line of rulings, if we talk about, is the landmark 2016 Constitution Bench ruling, in which the Supreme Court looked into the constitutional crisis in Arunachal Pradesh after the governor had imposed precedence rule in the state. So this is one of the instruments that has not been used in the recent past in order to exercise control by the center in the states. And a ruling has been passed with the respect to this particular usage, the arbitrary powers, right? So these are certain judgments. Now, if we talk about the reports of the central government, what were the reports or commissions which were formed by the central government to harmonize the balance between the center and the states? First, we need to talk about Sarkaria Commission report. The Sarkaria Commission report said that the governor should be bound by the aid and advice of the Council of Ministers, which enjoys majority in the State Legislative Assembly or the SLC, but he should be given his discretionary powers as well. So this is the first thing. That then second, but it did fall, his the Sarkaria Commission did fall a lot of into the ambit that yes, it should not be, the advice, aid and advice should not be unconstitutional, and if it's by the majority, then of course the governor is aided and bound by the Council of Ministers' advice. Then Panchi Commission. Now Panchi Commission was more dedicated towards resolving the issue with the Article 355 and 356, right? The emergency provisions. And here, the Panchi Commission did say that this should not be used arbitrarily. In the sense, it should not be used for political vendetta. And it also said that the chief minister should be appointed properly in order that the governor's discretionary power are not absolute or are not limitless, right? It also said that the governor, the incumbent, should be away from the local politics of the particular state prior to the appointment. That means it wanted to harmonize the balance as well as take or safeguard, basically, take care of the interest of the states as well. And second ARC report has also said that provisions related to the president's rule should be followed objectively and not subjectively. So these are the certain reports. Now, if we talk about the challenges, what is actually going wrong? First is different governments in the state and the center. Whenever that has happened, the government at the center and the government in the states are different. There is a lack of confidence and also loss of proper harmonization. So first problem is that. Secondly, meaning of discretion is not at all defined in the constitution, which makes it very open to interpretation. So definition, lack of definition is also a challenge. The constitution also does not say anything about the any other authority taking care of the or calling into question the absolute authority of deciding what falls into discretionary and what does not fall into the discretionary ambit of the governor. So the constitution should also, here it does not define any authority. The governor himself or herself is the authority. That is also a big challenge. And the frequency of minority government in the states, in the sense that because governments are forming in minority and there has been a noticeable frequency in that. If they don't properly enjoy majority, then what will happen? The governor will have to widen his discretionary powers, right? So these are the certain challenges. If we talk about the way forward, first way forward is taking into consideration the recommendations of the reports, which seriously have fall with all their weight in the favor of the states, in the sense that it should not be arbitrary and the federal structure should also be safeguarded, and also the unitary structure when it calls for should be also safeguarded. Now in the comment section, you have to tell me the timeline of these commissions. First is Sarkaria, which year basically. Second is Panchi Commission, then Rajamannar Commission, and the last one is second ARC report. You have to write their years in which they were formed, right? Then the case of S.R. Bommai, which has said that president's rule should be provided for or should be exercised only when there are real reasons for it, right? This also should be taken care of by the center. And the exercise of authority should be without any prejudice. President's rule, governor's rule, these all should not be used for political vengeance, but actually in the interest of the country. And lastly, to follow and respect the federal structure, of course. Federal structure should be safeguarded in order to take care of the perfect functioning of this country, because we are a diverse nation with diverse people, diverse language. So federal structure should also be respected, right? So I hope you have found this segment informative. Tomorrow we will turn up with another segment. Until then, stay updated and thank you so much for watching.